Well, hello everybody. This is our coldest morning so far this fall. And I've decided I'm coming out into the cabin to do some cooking and make lunch. I have the kindling ready to start the fire. It was minus 10 earlier this morning, and right now it's minus 9, so, and no snow. We had rain or whatever. Our snow is all gone. Lots of ice to slip on, though. I have the kindling set up in here, and what I'll do now is I'll get the fire going good, and then I'll go back to the house, and probably I'll come out all 2 times at least and add more wood until the cabin gets warm enough to stay in it. It is not very warm here right now. I'm always trying new fire starters. This little white block that just ignited very easily there is called Zip. I bought a package, I think 40 of them or something, for a couple of dollars, $2 or $3. I don't know what it might be made of, but it certainly ignites quick enough. And I have some, see my breath drifting in front of the camera here. It's cold in here. I think 0 degrees inside here, even though it's minus 9 outdoors. I have some cedar shingles and pieces of pine that have been split, and I guess that's going to ignite. I'll close the door and let it get a better draft. That only took a few minutes. It's burning very well. One match to ignite. Time to add the first bio brick here. I'll let that get going good, and I'll add another brick or two before I go back to the house. Well, I now have 3 bricks in there. And I guess as you can see, they're burning quite well. I'll close the draft down now so that it'll burn slower, and that way it'll produce more heat in the building here, warm the stove up, you know, the cast iron heated up, and I can go up to the house now for half, 3/4 of an hour or so. And well, the fire's been going for a little over an hour, hour and 10 minutes or so, I guess, and I came back out just in time to catch it and add 3 more bricks. Things burn very quickly in that stove. It's not very efficient, but it has the temperature up in here now to 7 degrees, and I checked before I left the house, it's -7 outside, so that's a reasonable increase, I guess, but it'll continue to get warmer. It'll be quite comfortable in here in another hour or so. I'm going to make some bread, hopefully, that's what I'm going to attempt to do, and some soup for a late lunch this afternoon. I prepared this mixture before I left the house. It's 1 cup of a multigrain flour, 1 cup of a white all-purpose flour, a teaspoon of dry yeast, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and I added 1 teaspoon of sugar just to give the yeast something to have a bit of a boost on. There's water out here in the kettle that's on the stove, but it was frozen. I guess it's starting to thaw up now. So I brought this thermos out with a little bit of warm water out of the hose. Try not to get this too wet, because I don't have a great deal of extra flour out here to knead into it. Bake this in the Coleman camp stove oven, hopefully, on the Coleman stove, the camp oven. Used it a few times in the past, but not a great deal. Finally got the bugs ironed out. There really weren't any bugs, it was just me not understanding how to use it, I guess. Water that I dare put in. put it out on the board here and knead it. Hopefully 2 cups of flour doesn't end up making a loaf that's too large for the little oven. I don't think it will. I hear the stove, the flame in the stove really starting to go over there now. I opened the draft up again after. Bricks, keep them going. Well, I'll need this for 4 or 5 minutes and then I'll come back to you. Well, I kneaded this, I guess, for about 4 minutes. I added a little extra flour to the board, but probably only incorporated about another tablespoonful or so into the loaf, so I was fortunate there. It's still a little tacky, but I like it to be a little tacky. I want it to be moist. This is actually a proofing container. That's what it was designed for, is to proof bread in. I use it mostly when I make my no-knead bread, but you don't have to cover it over with a towel or roll it in oil or anything like that before putting it in there. It'll just rise nicely inside of there, at least hopefully it will, that yeast and sugar activate. I'll now put it over on that little green stand, not too far from the stove, but not so close that it'll damage it either, where it's nice and warm, and I'll let it rise for an hour. Well, I've been back up to the house doing my Sherpa routine, carrying more things out here that I need for this expedition. I brought back the other camcorder, my Canon camcorder, because I thought I'd like to show you the setup that I'm using for the GoPro and making the rest of these clips. I like this attachment. Not sure now what it's called, but there's a clamp-like thing and all that staff that it's goes up to. The camera is flexible. You can bend it in many different directions and you can clamp it on almost anything. So far you've been clamped on that chair for a while, and when I started you were clamped on this wooden bucket hanging on the wall here that I got at the Ross Museum in Nova Scotia. Anyway, I thought you might like to see that. And when I said earlier that I was putting the dough to rise in that container on a little stand, that's the little stand that I was talking about, it's beside the stove. I've been gone again for about a half hour and the temperature is now 17 degrees in here. Well, you're back over there in the bucket again. I'm going to make a soup, a relatively simple soup, but I thought I would use some of these herbs that have been drying out here. Take one bay leaf. And I think this one is the celery soup. When they're dried, it's hard to tell the celery soup and the parsley apart. So I'm taking some of each. I'm quite sure this one's the parsley and the other one was the celery soup, though. Maybe just a bit of sage. Perhaps if I just, the thyme is dry enough that I can just get some leaves by rubbing it a bit. Thyme will use. You can hear me or not, because if I speak too softly, microphone and the GoPro doesn't pick up all that well. I didn't get too many leaves, so I think I'll take a snipping. Whoops. A snipping on the floor there too, I guess. Well, that will do for herbs. Now we'll put the soup together. While the bread is rising, I'll get started on my soup. I'm going to use the Knorr vegetable soup mix as a base We're going to add a lot of things, the herbs and whatever to it, but this makes a nice soup just by itself. But I find if I add some other things to it, I can, at least in my opinion, improve on it, I guess. And these are the herbs that I gathered a little while ago. Still got a few thyme twigs in there, I think, but most of it's just the leaves now and the bay leaf. And this is a bag of root vegetables, all from my garden. Still able to use all of them from my garden. See if I can remember everything that's in there. There's onion, rutabaga, potato, parsnip, and kohlrabi. Funny how root vegetables seem to be mostly white, okay, except for the rutabaga or turnip, a little bit of yellow there. But I may have to add some additional seasoning, but taste it and try that later on. The water in the kettle thawed and actually has started to simmer. It was frozen solid when I first came in here. Well, I'll put that on the Coleman stove and let it simmer. Well, while the bread was doing its first rising, I've been enjoying a book that I'm finishing. Sixpence House by Paul Collins. Very interesting book. A true story, I believe, of him and his wife moving to the village of Hay in Wales. A village that's famous for having so many bookstores. It's all bookstores of various sizes and descriptions. Anyway, I'm really enjoying the book. I just got a few pages left to go. I guess the bread has been rising for, I don't know, roughly an hour and a half, I think. And it's close to being double. When you use multi-grain flour, things don't rise as much as if it was just white flour. I'm going to say that that is double in bulk, anyway. Deflate it a little bit. Shape it into a round and let it do its second rising, which shouldn't take quite so long. This little bit of kneading and shaping redistributes the yeast and whatever, and gets it anxious to get growing again, I guess. On the peel on a bit of parchment paper, which I just put right into the oven when I'm ready. There's a pizza stone in that oven if you haven't seen my previous videos. I'll cover that with a towel and I'll put that back over to rise next to the fire. Well, while I have been sitting here reading, waiting for the oven to get up to temperature and whatever, there have been all kinds of birds visiting the bird table just outside the window, including my pair, male and female cardinals. But just a few minutes ago, I don't know what all was out there. The cardinals were there. There were doves on the ground and chickadees and sparrows and whatever at the feeder itself. Something frightened them. They left in such a hurry. Some of them even hit the windows here on the way out. I'm not sure what it might have been. I didn't see it, but over at the house in the last couple of weeks, I have had a sharp-shinned hawk who's feeding at my feeder. Problem being, his favorite food seems to be a nice, juicy morning dove, and I know he's had at least two, so possibly he flew over. Anyway, that is the loaf. I guess that's probably close to risen twice to what it was when I set it on the parchment paper. And I've cut a couple of slashes in it to let it expand. And now I'll take it over and put it in the oven. I've managed to get the oven up to, it was about 450 last time I opened. and it's down a little bit from there, which is what I want for this. Not sure how long to leave the loaf, never am with this thing. The oven temperature now is quite constant, but the loaves are so much smaller than I'm used to baking. So I'll check it in 15 to 20 minutes and see if I think it's done or not. Well, I'm going to say that it's done. It went in at 450, and I got the oven adjusted so that it's been in there for a half hour at about 400. It's looking relatively brown, so. Well, hopefully without upsetting either soup or tea, I will now cut this loaf. Still quite warm. Rested about 10 minutes or so, I guess. Finally, through the bottom crust. Oh, that looks fairly good, I think. I feel a little soft in the center still. So hard to judge things with the oven, not that accurate with the temperature, and not used to baking loaves this size. It is very good though. Give my soup a try here. Yeah, I like that too. And the unit didn't add any additional seasonings. Whatever is in the Nores for salt and whatever, I thought was quite enough. Okay. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this little afternoon with me out in the cabin. And thank you very much for watching.